Anderson Cooper 360. CNN, weeknights at 8 and 10 Eastern.
We begin tonight with more advertisers abandoning Rush Limbaugh and Limbaugh's latest explanation of why he labeled a Georgetown University law student, Sandra Fluke, a slut and a prostitute. Today, despite an apology on Saturday, the list of departing sponsors grew, now stands at 12. On Saturday, on his website, Limbaugh wrote the following, quote, "I chose the wrong words in my analogy of the situation. I do not mean a personal attack on Ms. Fluke." He goes on to say, "I think it is absolutely absurd that during these very serious political times we're discussing personal sexual recreational activities before members of Congress. I personally do not agree that American citizens should pay for these social activities." And he also said, "My choice of words was not the best, and in the attempt to be humorous, I created a national stir. I sincerely apologize to Ms. Fluke for the insulting word choices." Today, Limbaugh put a new spin on his apology, suggesting that the point he was making was right, even though he used the wrong words to make it.
The apology to her over the weekend was sincere. It was simply for using inappropriate words in a way I never do. And in so doing, I became like the people we oppose. I ended up descending to their level. It's important not to be like them, ever, particularly in fighting them. The old saw, you never descend to the level of your opponent or they win. That was my error last week. But the apology was heartfelt. The apology was sincere.
Well, that's, of course, up to you to decide. But keeping him honest, in his apology, Limbaugh actually mischaracterized what this student was saying in her testimony. She wasn't calling on taxpayers to pay for social activities. She was calling on the federal government to require that private health insurance cover birth control pills. Furthermore, she wasn't talking about this to allow for sexual activity in her testimony to congressional Democrats. She was talking about how important she thinks access to birth control pills are for women with a variety of medical conditions. Now, in his original comments, Mr. Limbaugh made it sound like she was talking about promiscuity. He chose to paint her as a sex addict who wants to sleep around at taxpayer expense.
What does it say about the college co-ed Susan Fluke, who goes before a congressional committee and essentially says that she must be paid to have sex? What does that make her? It makes her a slut, right? Makes her a prostitute. She wants to be paid to have sex. She's having so much sex she can't afford the contraception. She wants you and me and the taxpayers to pay her to have sex.
Well, he said that on Wednesday. Thursday, he said this.
So, Ms. Fluke, and the rest of you feminazis, here's the deal. If we are going to pay for your contraceptives and thus pay for you to have sex, we want something for it. And I'll tell you what it is. We want you to post the videos online so we can all watch.
That's Rush Limbaugh's portrait of Sandra Fluke and other women advocating mandated birth control coverage. Now, here's a portion of her testimony, what she actually said about a classmate who, like many women, takes the pill for reasons totally unrelated to birth control.
After months of paying over $100 out of pocket, she just couldn't afford her medication anymore, and she had to stop taking it. Without her taking the birth control, a massive cyst the size of a tennis ball had grown on her ovary. She had to have surgery to remove her entire ovary as a result.
Well, the pill, she says, might have prevented that. And in fact, oral contraceptives are prescribed for many other medical conditions, from uterine bleeding to ovarian diseases to disfiguring acne. That's why she said she's for a federal mandate that institutions offering health insurance must include birth control pills in the coverage. This is something that 28 states already do. It's not, as Limbaugh suggested, taxpayer-funded birth control or a federal subsidy to have sex.